Welcome back, students. So since we have learned quite a lot about the phenomena of resonance, now this would be the last module where we'll learn the application of resonance and proceed to the next electronic effect, that is the introduction of a hyperconjugation. All right. So when you talk about the application of a resonance, is basically the phenomena which helps us to understand the stability in the compound. So here we're going to learn the acidic strength of carboxylic acid. As we know the fact, any compound is acid if its conjugate base is stable. So let's look at the structure of carboxylic acid, and if it donates a proton, it forms a conjugate base which is called as a carboxylate ion, as we have seen earlier. Whereas now we are having two structures, one is a carboxylic acid and other is carboxylate ion. We will try and draw the resonating structure of both of this, because both of them are having lone alternate pi condition present in them, which is one of the conditions which makes the compound eligible to show phenomena of resonance. So look at the carboxylic acid structure, the one which is to the left. If we show delocalization over here, we'll get a resonating structure which can be simply drawn like this. So since the lone pair from the oxygen atom has delocalized, it is experiencing loss of a lone pair, so will carry a positive charge, and the doubly bonded oxygen gaining one additional electron pair, so carrying a negative charge, which means now this newly obtained resonating structure carries a positive and the negative charge, which means this structure is the charge separated structure. Now try to work on the phenomena of a resonance in this structure right here, which is nothing but the carboxylate ion. So we again have a lone alternate pi condition present over here. So if we show delocalization, we'll get one more resonating structure which is equivalent of this carboxylate ion. And you can see that there's only negative charge which is getting dispersed, delocalized. So I will say that in this structure 1 and 2, which are the equivalent structure, you will find that these equivalent structures are charge delocalized structure. And whenever you get a charge separated structure, it is relatively a less stable structure. On the other hand, charge delocalized, which means if only one charge is getting dispersed, delocalized over several atoms, then that delocalized structure is always a more stable structure than the other. And now you think about, why are we calling this as an application? We say that any compound is acid if its conjugate base is stable. So in case of carboxylic acid, we saw that the conjugate base was a carboxylate ion, which is giving us charge delocalized structure, which is more stable. More stable the conjugate base is, more stable is the acid from which that conjugate base is obtained. So likewise, student, if you try and work on the sulfonic acid, or if you try and work on the phenol, you will find that the charge delocalized structures are going to be more stable due to phenomena of resonance. So phenomena of resonance can simply justify the acidic strength of the compounds. Well, having known this, now we are going to learn or see a simple sequence of acidic strength, but the most important one. So remember, if you talk about the several acids, the sulfonic acid is the strongest among all because its resonating structures are more stable. And after sulfonic acid, the next acidic is carboxylic acid, followed by we have a carbonic acid, and then we have phenol. After phenol, the structure or the compound which comes most acidic is methanol. Check out here, we have a methanol. Then relatively weaker acid is a water. And then we again have any other alcohol. Student, please look at this. Methanol is the only exceptional alcohol which is more acidic than water. Rest all other alcohols are weaker acid than water. And after this, we have alkyne, then we have ammonia, and then we get alkene, followed by alkanes. So this is a simple order of acidic strength of several compounds, and you got to remember this. All right, students. Now, having said that, we are going to learn application of resonance, and this is what was the application of a resonance. Now we'll see introduction to the phenomena of a hyperconjugation, and there are several more names coming up right there. We'll justify each one of this name, but for the timing, let's look at this reaction. So we have tertiary butyl halide. When this tertiary butyl halide is brought in presence of a polar solvent like water, again we learn what is mean a polar, then the CH bond heterolytically breaks, and which means the bond pair between C and X have been completely taken by X. So the carbon has lost bond pair and therefore produces a positively charged species like this. This positively charged species, where positive charge is carried by carbon, is called as carbocation. Now let's take that carbocation over here and remove all this methyl group. We'll get the structure like this. So this is a general representation of carbocation. Let's take a replicate of that. So we are taking four such general representation of a carbocation. And now in structure number one right there, we are fulfilling all the valencies, let's say by methyl groups. So now that carbocationic carbon, which is carrying a positive charge, is attached to three more carbon. So the nature of the carbon carrying positive charge is tertiary. So we call it as tertiary carbocation. Same way, if we take two methyl group attached to such carbon, you will call it as the secondary carbocation, since it is attached to two other carbon. So if we move further, if I am fulfilling two valences with HS and one with methyl, the nature of cationic carbon is primary, and if I fulfill all the valences with HS, I will call it as the methyl carbocation, since it looks like methyl. So the nature of carbon carrying positive charge decides the nature of carbocation, and it is said that among all this, the order of stability is found to be tertiary the most, then secondary, then primary, and methyl is least stable carbocation. And why is the order so can be proven by the phenomena of a hyperconjugation. So in the very next module, we'll try and prove this order, and with respect to this, we will learn the phenomena of hyperconjugation. But we'll stop here in this module. Thank you.